I'm Ibi Latour. I'm head of creative of Ziggo Sport. And I work with NEP closely on augmented reality related cases to build studio sets and set extensions and props. Well, we started a year ago with this whole adventure, I call it, with NEP and with augmented reality. Before this, we had a little studio which was half of, no, not even half of what we have now. So augmented reality opened up a lot of new opportunities. And basically, we're using it at the moment for almost every show we have. We are a sports channel, so we have a lot of graphics to show. So we use it for every show in lots of different ways. We use it for set extensions. Mm-hmm. We use it to add on extra graphics and statistics. We use it to build a complete environment. We use it to show props. Basically, it's all over our shows. Challenge I feel with using augmented reality is to get it more integrated into the set and also into the experience, I think, for the viewer. Because at the moment it's looking glamorous, but it's always a sort of an add-on effect. That's of course because we are pioneering with all the companies. But I think also with the crew working on it and the talent and the commentators, we need to find a way to make AR more accessible for everyone and sometimes more believable, if you know what I mean, more real. But let's in the first circle, like in the production environment, in our colleagues and competitors, mm-hmm. People definitely notice it, and they say like, oh, you got a big show going on and blah blah, and this, you know, it's really an adventure. But as I say, also that depends for the goal of the coming years is that it becomes more. People have to get used to it, you know what I mean? So yeah, of course, augmented reality gives you the opportunity to build an add-on to reality in a different way. You can prepare everything in post-production, or pre-post-production. For instance, when we used the Formula One car, yeah, it would have been unthinkable to get Max Verstappen's car into the studio just like that. And so this really makes things possible that weren't possible before. And you can also make a complete studio out of it, just like that, like from one week to the other. And I never met a head of production who just would sign off a studio built just like that. So. Yes, and it gives opportunity to experiment and to tweak, which is, of course, in real life with real set design or using props, much more difficult.
Hi, I'm Roel. I'm a lead graphics designer at NEP, and I'm doing mainly augmented reality. I've been using Zero Density's virtual studio software since the beginning of 2017. Mm-hmm. And NEP has been using it for over 1.5 years now. The virtual studio from Zero Density gives us the power to make augmented reality inside Unreal Engine. Yeah, so the great thing about the virtual studio production inside Zero Density's reality is the fact that the shading between the real and the virtual environment match so well. So we get virtual objects which reflect into the real world. We have virtual objects casting shadows in the real world. And we have the real world reflecting into the virtual object, which all makes it match insanely well. We're currently using it to make every element more grounded. So for example, we have a lot of sports shows going on in the studio, and we have a Formula One car standing in the studio, and because it has the shadows and it has the reflections in the real floor, it just seems like it's really there. So the preparation of a virtual studio after we have created it, so from entering the studio to making everything visible, takes around 3 days, in which we set up the keyer, and we set up the tracking, and which in this case we use the mo-sys tracking, and we set up the virtual set, and we measure the environment. and then we just turn it on. So the cool thing we added in the last year is that in multiple studios we use data-driven elements, meaning that either from Excel or from an external party, data can be sent to the Reality API, and it will drive, for example, graphs or elements inside a screen to visualize the score during a football match or to make bar charts rise from the ground. So that's a nice addition. And because we have such a great partnership with you guys, it makes it easier to improve the overall augmented reality. And anything we suggested in the last couple of years has been integrated. So that makes it really good to work with you guys.
I'm Vince. I'm a graphics operator and I'm a Star Trekker engineer. So I usually make maps in studios using reflective stickers and creating with mo-sys a star map that can be used for tracking for AR. And normally during the weekends, I'm doing AR as an operator. When we operate our systems, normally come in the weekends, roughly 3-4 hours before the broadcast, I start up all systems and I load, as you can see, we have a big studio here. There's multiple programs running simultaneously and or after another. So we load the appropriate playlist for our engine, and then we gather all our assets, load them into the zero density application and make a rundown list of it. And then we run them one by one, test if everything works okay. And when the program starts, we simply operate the machine. No, it's not hard to operate the machines. It's actually pretty easy to do. You simply press the button and your graphics come to life, and we can reverse. We have some alterations, so we can change our graphics if we want to, or if the director wants a different location of our objects, we can move them all around. It's very flexible to use the graphics with this machine. Well, we've updated our system from 10.04, 10.06 to 12.16. And we see major improvements in the smoothness and in the sturdiness of the system itself. So it's pretty promising. So we're going to dry test it for a few days and see how we can work with it for this weekend.
My name is Ralf van Vegten. I'm the CIO for NEP in the Netherlands and also responsible for the graphics department here. Yeah, we use AR at NEP for quite a few years now. And 2 years ago, we decided that we should make this our main proposition. So it should be not only a gimmick, but it should be a replacement for physical sets. So we invested a lot of time, money and resources to search for the best products in the market that we could combine into one proposition. And we have chosen Zero Density and mo-sys to be our main suppliers for this proposition. So in 2017, we made 1,100 hours of live shows with AR. So we have we've found a lot of stuff that work, but also a lot of stuff that doesn't work. And we're currently in the second round of developments, to find the best solutions and also the best designs for our customers. And I believe that in the coming years, we will be able to bring it to such a level that it will be made available to customers that use it on a daily basis. So complete virtual sets on a daily basis that will replace physical sets. And that's the ultimate goal that we have here at NEP. We found Zero Density at NAB, I think, almost 2 years ago. And then we thought, okay, we need to meet these guys and talk to them about how we can use their software. And then we had a project that didn't go completely as planned. And then we called them, and the next day they were here in the Netherlands, and they helped us out with this project and made it into a success. And that started off the relationship. Yeah, so obviously we also encountered some issues on the way to where we are now, but they always have been very helpful, and we're always open to the suggestions that we made. So together with Zero Density, we made a lot of steps, and we are where we are now, where we use it on a daily basis. We have happy customers that are doing things that they couldn't do without this proposition. What we do differently is that we truly believe that this will be a change of the complete broadcast market. So, and if you believe that it will be a change, you need to lead the change and invest money, time, resources to develop this into a situation where it works every day. So, you know, on the way to where we are today, we found out some difficulties, things that work and that don't work. And because we have seen all these things, we have been able to develop it to a stage where we are today. And I really believe that we will make a lot of steps in the coming months that will convince even our toughest customer that this will be a change of the way you make television.